Today I want to talk about skillful disgust and what the hell does that mean. I kind of made that up actually, but what I used to say or be told by a mentor of mine was that extreme disgust with what you're doing can sometimes be a really good thing. It's like if you think about the scale of like how you recover emotionally, if you're depressed, that's actually worse than being really angry because it's lower on the tone scale. So if someone's really depressed and you get them to be angry, you've actually improved their situation because angry means you actually give a crap, whereas depressed, you're just out of the game, you know, and you can move your way up to euphoria at the top or whatever is at the top. So when you're disgusted, that's probably somewhere around anger, irritation, disgust with your results. Sometimes just utter disgust for what you're doing can be beating yourself up. It can be counterproductive. It could be not useful. But when you are skillfully disgusted, when you're skillfully disgusted, I think what that means to me is you are using it as a tool to get better. And you just, when I'm disgusted in the right way, I come in just very focused, almost a little angry, but in a healthy way, if that's possible. I mean, like a positive anger maybe. And it's just kind of I'm going to wait today and I have a few ideas of what I want to do. Or if it's not during the day, it's like, I'm going to wait until my strategy lines up of the stuff I've studied that I've been successful with. And I don't really care if I miss anything, but what I'm not going to do is do something that when I have to look at where I got in and got out, I'm going to be ashamed of what I did. And it's just not the time for that for me right now because of what's been happening. And that disgust really presses me in a direction of clarity on the next trade better be a good one. And if it's a loser, that's okay, but it's got to be a loser that is like a professional loser. It's like I got in, I knew where I was wrong, I got out, and I feel good about that. That's professional losing. I mean, you have to take losers. So you get good at taking losers. That's part of it. When you're trading well, you take losers even when they're not losers. I mean, you take losers and make small amounts of money even, but the trade idea didn't work. Or you take one just because time has elapsed or whatever. And those are good, examples of you thinking and feeling the market on time and not having to wait until your stop loss is tripped. But that's a different topic. But you can use disgust in a really good way. And I found that it's when I really get blown up and I'm really off track, it's kind of almost a depression type feeling for a few days. You just don't want to get out of bed. Everyone knows how that feels. So I need to kind of get myself to the next level. But when you get to that disgust level, that can be a good spot. You can use that. I'm not saying you want to be disgusted, but sometimes you just happen to be there. You can use that to really channel it into clean trading for that day. And that feels good. It feels good to know that, I'm doing everything I can in here, but this is the emotion that comes up today. Let's use it to my advantage. Let's use it to be clean. What I always used to say to myself was when I was day trading, I would plot my trades and I could see, geez, buddy, you're at the middle of the bar, you're at the middle of the range on everything. It's not good. Either you buy the breakout at the top or you buy the bottom, near the bottom 20% or whatever of the range that you think is bullish. Don't get stuck in the middle, left and right. And when I would be disgusted about a bad day, that was the next day, it was like, okay, whatever I do today, I'm not going to be stuck in the middle of these bars. I'm going to wait for a retest. I'm going to wait for a breakout, whatever it is, but I'm not going to get caught there because I can't manage my risk there. I'm just chasing prices. And that's not good for me. It's not a long-term strategy that's going to lead to success on my entries and my execution. And that would, it would kind of turn me around. It really would. So, I'm not really in that spot right now. I'm in a pretty clear spot. I've taken some time off in the last few days and I'm continuing to go over all the things that I did really well the last year, especially, but I even went back to 2018 and found all my best trades. I broke them down into groups and there's like four or five groups, but stupid news group's a bigger one. Probably my biggest successes have come from that. And just really getting to know those trades, why they work well. Am I taking enough out of them? How long do they last? Is there a better way to enter them? And that reinforces what's been working and what I'm good at. And it's going to kind of backstop me for 2021. It's going to be what I really lean on. And chasing other things that are low-hanging fruit per the last podcast about the energetic cost of doing that is going to be less of a thing for me. It's just not where I'm at right now. It's where I used to be at maybe when I was younger, earlier in my career, but it's not even an age thing either. It's just how long you've been doing it and where you want to go. And eventually there's just like a different kind of building process you want to do and you want to scale yourself differently for your whole life, for your family balance, for peace. So when I do this stuff, this might sound, some people might connect with this and some people might not, but when I trade in a way that kind of realigns with who I want to be now, there's this peace that comes over me. It's just like, it's easy to go in, and it's fun no matter what, but it's more of a, how can I describe it? More of a, just a relaxed state of being, kind of a waiting for things to come and get me. Like, I'm prepared and I'm ready and I'm prepared, but I'm also not, it's an active pause. We've talked about this before. It's like, I'm ready, but I'm paused. And that gives me the state of, you know, that's the perfect state for me. That's where I know I can aggressively do something, but I'm probably not going to do anything. I don't really care if I don't do anything. And that's the spot I want to stay in. And when I'm in that spot, everything's just easy. It's peaceful. It flows. It's fun. And it's the opposite of that angsty, it's busy, I got to do something. It's been a few weeks and I need to make some results happen. And nothing good comes from that. And I think I've told the story before about when you decide that, like, the story is I had an appointment at, you know, noon, and I was trading in Chicago, so it was 8:30 Central Time, the market opened. I had a lunch appointment with somebody at noon, somebody I didn't know that well, so I couldn't really skip it. So I thought, okay, what I'm going to do is make some money and then go to my appointment. And of course, I have a terrible losing day, and then it bleeds into the next day sometimes even. Well, so why does that happen? It's because subconsciously you're telling yourself, I need to make money and then I'll go. Well, if you say I need to make money and then I'll go, that's what you're really saying when you are trying to trade before that. You're seeking and looking for something to make money. You're not letting something come to you. And when you're seeking and looking and not allowing, you lose because there's no patience there. There's no inspiration there. There's just like hunting for trades. And people who hunt for trades, and we've all done it, it doesn't really work that well. Instead, you're an opportunist and it comes to you. And when you have that appointment and you want to make money before the appointment, there's not a lot of patience in that statement. So that's what happens. So that was a big one for me. Happened many times, but just to really think about that. So it's like, okay, well, I probably should just shut it down that day or do something else and just watch from a background. And if something pulls me in, great. But anyways, that can ignite the disgust too that I started the podcast with when I start doing that stuff. But so I'm going to get into the next podcast about some bigger picture next year thinking stuff that I'm working on. But for now, I just wanted to stick with the disgust topic for this one.